Hey everybody, so we're back here. Got a nice little toy out here today. It's my brother-in-law's gun. Y'all know him as Mr. S from the infamous underwear video. It's a Ruger Security 9. Nice little piece. Ruger is out of Southport, Connecticut. They do have manufacturing facilities in, I want to say it was Newport, in, New Hampshire. There's one out in Arizona and one down in South Carolina as well. cool little gun, man. It's got a nylon frame with glass infused, apparently. Does have the little trigger dingus, a little safety here. External safety out here. See, right here. Holds 15 plus one rounds. Nice double stack magazine. Midsize pistol. Chambered in 9mm, has the name Security 9. I don't know if you can see that. But we're gonna pop off some caps with this bad boy here and see how it works. Dr. S do some shooting and see how he does. Man, this little Ruger, it's actually not too snappy. It's got a good recoil management. Don't know if I showed you that. The internal hammer, very similar to the LCP2. Nice little gun, especially for the money. I want to say the price point is somewhere between $300 and $400 for this guy. He got it for his 21st birthday, so happy birthday. It was $250, you said? Oh, right on, so that's even better. Good gun, especially for $250. let's rock out to the music, man. So yeah, let's do a little bit more shooting with it. Seems to be pretty accurate. It's got nice sights. Look down the sights. I don't know how well y'all can see that. Very similar almost to a Glock style of sight, but yeah, man. Ran through the whole magazine and it failed to lock back on the last bullet, but it was in fact definitely empty. I checked to clear the chamber and there was nothing in it, nothing popped out. It ejected the case just fine. So we'll do a little bit more shooting with it and see if we have any more issues. I mean, I really wouldn't call that a major issue or anything, but just maybe a mishap. All right, cool. We'll be right back. take a look at this Ruger 9 compared to a M&P Shield 9. Small, medium, large. It's my SIG P320. So that tells you this is a mid-size. It's a little bit bigger than the compact Shield, but not quite as big as a full size. So it's still a nicely concealable gun for concealed carry. So far it's really good. I mean, at that price point for $250, I don't think you can go wrong. It's got a complete rail for your slide. I don't know if I showed you the internal hammer. Again, like I said, very similar to the LCP2. Same type of setup as far as the hammer system goes, the internal hammer. And the trigger dingus. The famous dingus. Everybody likes to play with their dinguses. Let's see how a girl handles the security 9. This is Nurse N, that's Dr. S's girlfriend. How handle? How'd that handle for you? You like it?
Feels great. Yeah, it's pretty smooth.
Yeah, it's smoother smooth, than mine. smoother than the Shield?
Yeah.
All right. It's got a pretty clean trigger pull and a pretty short reset. Ready? Let's see if you can hear it. Right there. Not bad. Probably, I want to say it was rated at like a 5-pound trigger pull. It's got a real short reset. It's pretty nice shooting so far. I almost think it's a little bit better than that Taurus that I bought. I wouldn't say it's as good as my SIG, but it's definitely very nice. I would definitely purchase one of these little Ruger Security 9s. Yes. This one actually, it says here, Ruger Prescott, Arizona, USA. So this was made out of their Arizona manufacturing facility. Ruger's been around since 1949, been around for a good many years. They make good quality firearms. So we're going to continue to take a few more shots with this thing and see how it keeps on performing for us.
We've already gone through 200.
Yep, the more I shoot this thing, the more I like it. It's got a real comfortable grip. It swoops up here pretty good, so it doesn't dig into my finger like most other firearms I've picked up do since I got these big gorilla hands. It's comfy, man. The way I look at it, a good pistol that you choose should be like a nice pair of sneakers. You want them to fit just right and feel comfortable while you're wearing them, so that's the same thing with a gun. You want it to grip good and feel good in your hand while you're gripping it. You don't want any kind of discomfort. So this one's got it all, man. A good price, a good feel, good recoil management system. So definitely like it. Instance where it didn't lock back has not happened again. We've probably put a couple hundred rounds through this guy so far. That's what we're shooting today. We're shooting some Winchester 9mm 115 grain ball ammo, and we also ran some Sig Sauer 115 grain full metal jackets. Seems like it'll just about eat anything you throw at it, as far as factory ammo goes. Maybe after I do another big batch of reloads, maybe I see if I can get my brother-in-law back out here and we can shoot it with some reloads and do another update video and see how it goes in after we, you know, torture it a little bit more and put some more ammo through it. All right, everybody. Well, that's been the Security 9 by Ruger. Definitely a good buy. So, you know, if you're feeling itchy and you don't have a bunch of change in your pocket and you can scrape up about, you know, $250 to $300, you can get yourself one of these. All right, man. Well, sounds good. Till next time, everybody. As always, have fun.